This here's a quick little video about this old pocket camera, manufactured around 1916, according to the patents plate on the inside of it. It is a 120 Kodak camera called a 1A. So I'm going to show you how to open it up. First, I'm going to show you how to load the film. It takes 120 spools. So basically what you would do, hold on a second. I'll do this the easy way. This is how you would release it. Is it gonna come out this time? No, it's hard to remove it. All right. It's a bellows camera, folding camera, of course. And I'm going to release that latch in there. There, that slides right out. Does take a little bit of effort. And there you have it. Manufactured, I guess, between 1915 and 1924 or 1926. The nameplate on the inside of this one says 1916 was the patent for Canada and Australia. I think it was 1914, 1915 for the US. So I'm going to show you how to put your film in it. I'm going to do it this way because it's easier for me to pry this open when this is open. So here, you slide this out of the way. And then you just pull up on that. And there you have it. It's even got the original spool in it. Made of metal. Look at that 120 film right on it. So you would put your film in here. This is your take up spool. You put it in there, pull this out a little bit, and then of course you would wind it. And as you wind your film, you can see the number imprinted on the paper. This back here has an odd little feature. When you take your shot, if you want to write something on the paper, like maybe the time you took it or maybe your settings or what have you, it will imprint it onto the film. You close that door, move on to your next. But as you can see, I don't know how easy that is to see. Oh, sorry for banging that there. Wait. Patent in the US, 1916 for Canada. So this one was probably manufactured in around that time. And it's in relatively good shape, I think, for its age. I mean, the bellows look like they're in pretty good shape. I couldn't see any cracks in them. I couldn't see any light leakage. There's the one lens. I'm going to clear that lens a little bit later. So let's just lock this back into place here. So we'll just do this. So once you have your film loaded, oh, one second, I did that the wrong way. There you go. This side in first, push it down, lock it into place. Start winding your film until you see the number one, take your shot, and off you go. I have no reason to believe that this will not work. The shutter seems functional. You got four shutter settings. You got T, which is time. So you press, you leave it open, and it closes. You have B for bulb. So you press and hold, and it stays open as long as you keep your finger on the shutter. And then you have 25th of a second. And 50th of a second. Now the thing I find interesting is the aperture settings. So there. So you got aperture setting at 1, 2, 3, and 4. I don't know. I'm not really sure what that aperture setting would be. If it'd be 6 or 8. So let's just guess. Let's just guess 6. Maybe 8. Who knows? Anyway, trying to experiment with it will give me an idea of, you know, just how well it works. There used to be a lens on the front of these, apparently, and they took that lens element out because in some of the models, or most of the models, there'd be ghosting and flaring, so they decided to take that out completely. And of course, your composition would be done through this. This is, of course, your portrait. And if you want to shoot landscape, you just flip the camera on its side and compose your shot through this here. Kind of a nifty little rig. I mean, it's 100 years old. And it still works. I mean, do they build anything today that'll last 100 years? I mean, really? Is there anything today that they you know, any piece of equipment that has that kind of staying power or potential longevity? I'm doubtful. Number one pocket, Kodak. And of course, when it's time to put it away, release the catch. Fold your... goes back into place. Push these two little items in, and it folds up neatly. It's heavy too. I mean, it's metal. There's no plastic in this one. This is not a Bakelite camera, that's for sure. And like I said, if I find it easier to put the film in it. Here, wait. Ah, there you go. You can do it that way. I just found it easier to do it with the everything folded out, but the bellows look like they're in good shape. That lens is going to be cleaned. Grab my little lens pen, take a quick. I'm just happy the shutter works because I've got some other cameras, some box cameras that, you know, the shutter's sticky or it's just not working right. And I've been trying to lubricate it and get it to work. I have to clean the other side of it too. I have a lens cleaner from my glasses that I no longer own. Don't mind me. This is one of those little cloths that aren't supposed to leave fiber, so I'm gonna have to do the other side. I can probably take that off there. Oh, look at that. There we go. Since I'm here, I think I'll clean that with some proper... normally I'd use alcohol or this lens cleaner. Serious, for, like I said, for my eyeglasses, but I haven't wore eyeglasses in 5 or 6 years. Let's see, how's that look? Not bad. Yeah, it's pretty good. No scratches or major blemishes or anything. Want to make sure that you get it the right way around when you put it back into the camera. Don't want to cross thread it. There we have it. So, yeah, you load your film. Put everything back into place. Snap, lock. Open. This took me a long time to figure this out. I'm not gonna lie. The reason being is I didn't want to force it, And I did look around on the internet and I found that everybody else's camera just sort of, they just grabbed, they pushed a button here. There's a piece of, there's something missing here. They would just press it and pull it out. Well, that's not an option for me. So basically I would release it. Oh, see, this is hard to do. The first time it worked fine. Second time, not so much. She's a fussy one. What am I missing here? There we go. Yeah, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to put some force into it. So anyhow, thanks for watching. I hope you found this somewhat useful, somewhat informative. I'll be like shooting a roll of film through this probably in the near future. And when I do, I'll put those images online and we'll see if it was worth it. All right, thanks for watching. So if you want to set your depth of field, or I should say your focal length, there's a little slider on the side here and that's how it's adjusted. So basically if you want to shoot close up, 6 foot, under 6 feet, you'd slip it to there, 8 feet, 25 feet, and 100 feet. It's anybody's guess, you know, how close that would be. Would that be 3 feet? Would that be 1 foot? Who knows? But anyway, that's how you would do your focal length.